Now we will talk about cubic interpolation method for finding minimum of a function of one variable. As usually, we will start with function given on interval. So we know that the minimum of function f is located between the points a0 and b0. And the basic idea, if we know values of function and its slopes, its derivatives in two points, a and b, we can build a cubic polynomial which has the same values and the same derivatives at those points. And then we will minimize this polynomial and use this new point to continue our iterative process. But before, as in quadratic case, similarly to quadratic case, we will start with so-called V combination. We check whether slopes of the function look in the direction of each other, like in this picture. Slope in A is negative and slope in B is positive, to ensure that the minimum of our function and also minimum of quadratic polynomial will be inside the interval. So when we get this new point, we of course compute function value and derivative, and we check whether derivative is positive or negative at this new point. If it's positive, then we know that our minimum is located on the left subinterval, like it's written here, otherwise in right subinterval, and we continue with new subinterval. We just move the end point of interval to the new point B or A, depending on which subinterval we use. And also we use so-called safeguard. Sometimes cubic interpolation may be not very good, especially in initial steps. So the progress, the reduction of uncertainty interval may be slow. And in this case, we can perform bisection step as safeguard. But when we are close to solution, usually cubic iterations converge very, very fast. And the method is one of most practical methods for one-dimensional optimization.